Hi, my name is Silo Mulele.
And I'm Zirka.
We're here to present the detection of lightning atmospherics in the city.
We're concerned mainly with the VLF band, or the radio frequency band. It spans from 300 Hz to 30 kHz, and we want to detect man-made signals such as VLF transmitters, as well as natural signals such as whistles and spherics.
This is an example of a typical whistler and a spheric that was measured from Stanford VLF system.
This is the old VLF system. This is the solar panel connected to the battery, which stores power. And these are the cables of the antenna, the loop antenna, connected to the matching transformer, which is connected to the preamplifier. This is our receiver bandpass filter, which has a band of 100 Hz to 100 kilohertz, and this is connected to the microprocessor, which we use to sample data. Zaid will introduce the new VLF system that we designed.
The new system is similar to the old system, with the main difference being that the impedance matching transformer is excluded. The signal goes straight from the antenna to the amplifier. A single loop magnetic field antenna is used with an approximate area of 30 square meters. A variable gain inverting amplifier is used to control the gain. An 8th order active high pass filter and a 10th order active low pass filter are used to create a pass band of 500 Hz to 47 kHz. The signal is then sampled by the analog input of a one board at 96 kHz. The power supply, the amplifier, the filter, and the one board are cascaded together to form the entire system. A simple power monitor circuit makes use of a voltage divider, Hall effect current sensors, and an Arduino Nano to monitor power consumption of the device. The VLF receiver system is found to consume an average of approximately 9.5 watts.
This table shows the analysis of the old VLF system and the new VLF system. These are the results that were depicted from the new system, and these are the flaws that were shown in the old system. These are the measured results. The old system suffers from a lot of noise and harmonics, whereas the new system has a visible transmitter at 19 kHz and has less noise. Here are clear lightning atmospherics. They can be heard by a cricking sound.